Hey, VC here. So today we're talking about the Old Toll House time trial. Now, this is a long-standing event. It happens at the end of the year. And I did a full-blown like race day vlog, talking to the camera, setting up shots, stayed in the RV, talked to people. Anyway, it just wasn't really coming together as a good video. And when I was diving into the data, I thought it'd be way more interesting to look at the fact that the last time I did a full-on poop pants effort on this climb was in 2012, which is the first year that I was actually riding. I started riding in 2010, but that doesn't really count because I rode like four or five times, then my son was born, and then 2011, again, just, you know, I had a newborn kid and I didn't really ride much. So technically, I guess 2012 is really when I started. Now, I did 42 minutes, 22 seconds then. Currently, the KOM was 34 minutes on this, so we're going to see how I did. Now, my recovery score, not super good. I had kind of been in a funk, as Whoop was telling me, for a while now, but I'm feeling good. And here's some pictures of roughly what I looked like back in 2012. The one where I'm in the red and white kit, that's actually proper 2012. The black and red kit, that was 2013, but you can kind of get a sense of your boy. So now going side by side here, right, 2012, I had put in 248 hours. I weighed about 180 pounds. I didn't have a power meter then, but I think I did my first power meter effort in 2013, and that was 289 watts for 20 minutes. So probably a little bit under that, given that time. Currently, 4,000 hours, 150 pounds, 355 watts for 20 minutes. Break down some of the hours across the years. So in 2010, like 10 hours, then my son was born. 2011, 25 hours. And that's, again, I just wasn't really like into cycling super hard. I'd ride maybe once a week or once a month sometimes. But in 2012, I really got bit by the bug. You know, 248 hours. Then in 2013, started really proper racing, 497 hours, 387 for 2014, 392, 421. 2018 seems a little bit of a blip. There's a lot of hours there compared to the other hours, and I want to say that it doubled some rides, so I'm not sure if that's accurate. But anyway, total time from, say, the 2000 end or the end of 2012 to now, 3,900 hours. So 4,000 hours later, how much faster am I? And really, since time is an illusion and doesn't work in a linear fashion, there is no time I could do on this climb that could justify spending 4,000 hours on the bicycle. Now, you can't just compare 4,000 hours to performance. That I'm not a pro cyclist, so that's not, you know, every hour I'm on the bike, it's not about how fast I'm getting. There's so much more that I've gained out of cycling in the last 8 years that are just irreplaceable, right? The friendships that I've made and the fitness that I've gained and the confidence, just there's so much about it that I just love. I mean, I just straight up love riding bikes. And so when you look at it as a whole, I think 4,000 hours is acceptable. It's still a lot, but you know, it's not all about performance. But still, I mean, after you've done 4,000 hours, you would really like to see some gains. And so how much gains are we making here? Now, I am coming into this with zero vegan excuses. I am feeling better maybe than I have ever felt. My power is way up. My weight is way down. Usually I'm about 155, 160 if I'm eating, you know, junk at night. And so just in the past month or so, I have gotten, I don't know, man, super lean. I've cut out all of my late night snacks. That's basically all I've done, just the tubs of ice cream and potato chips while laying in bed. And so that has gotten me down to about 150. Which is insane. I mean, I'm 6'2", so that's about the limit, you know, but I'm feeling really good at this weight. It feels sustainable. I'm not starving myself. I'm not hating life. You know what I mean? I'm getting to eat just tons and tons of food at night, healthy food, delicious food, but you know, I just cut out some of that junk at night. And so I went out and I did a power test a couple days prior to this, where I did 20 minutes at 350 watts at this new weight. And so that was huge. I couldn't believe that I actually did that kind of watts at this weight. So then I was feeling pretty confident, but I based this effort off of those numbers. So with, you know, an FTP of somewhere probably close to 330, 340, given those numbers, you know, that's kind of what I was holding at. I was holding around 330. That was my goal. Hold 330 average until the last, say, 5-6 minutes of the climb, and then just empty the tank. Now, I had started a little bit too hard in the very beginning, so I was above that average. I think I was around 345 after the first like 2 minutes. And then so I actually had to bring it down. And I was just feeling super good. And when I'm looking at my heart rate here and how, you know, flat my power was across the board, I really did pace it pretty well. I paced it too well, to be honest. I definitely left a little bit of time out on the road just for how easy I was going in the beginning. But dude, I suck. All the time I think I'm good, I'm fit, I'm light, I'm awesome, I'm confident. And then I go and I try to perform and it just doesn't happen, right? Just never, it never is what I think it's gonna be. There's always the hammer drops and I blow into pieces. And so I'm expecting that to happen here. I'm expecting at some point during this, you know, really big climb, that I'm going to start feeling like turds and not perform. And, you know, I had been hyping up my fitness a little bit coming into this. So, you know, I was going to feel stupid. I was just kind of waiting for the negative aspects to come. But bro, they never came. I was feeling so freaking good. And actually at a couple times where my wife pulled up to the side of me to get like the side shot, you know, I was talking with her. Again, you can see my heart rate just, you know, 181, 180 is not, that's like threshold for me, right? Everything here, my power, how I was feeling, it's all threshold, which means I could have gone harder. I should have been able to go harder because the KOM is 34 minutes. You know, I'm trying to go something sub 40. To remind you, in 2012, I did 42 minutes, 22 seconds. So here I am definitely trying to beat that. And here's what's really crazy is I started taking ketones, and I don't want to talk about it too much. I'm going to be weird about it. But so for me personally, ketones have really changed my performance by an outstanding amount. If you don't know what ketones are, basically that's the energy source from fat. So you have two energy sources, you have sugar and you have fat. Now, typically, sugar stores are, you know, way more efficient to deliver energy. And if you run out of sugar stores, that's what a bonk is, right? You're out of sugar, so now your body has to derive energy from fat, which is ketones, but it's a very slow, inefficient process. Now, if you're fat adapted and you're doing intermittent fasting, then you can use those ketones at a higher output. Anyway, I'm on ketones, not a crazy amount, 5 grams. It's very inexpensive. It's $5 a bottle, okay? So here, what's super strange is that I could have done this power for twice as long, but I could not have gone twice as hard, if that makes any sense. So basically anything above zone 4, getting into zone 5, it was really difficult. I felt like I was going to blow up. It was really hard to maintain that. But anything below, I was crushing. Now here, I think I'm super aero. I think I'm the most aero human on the planet. In my mind, this is what I look like, that I am just crushing. But now that I look back on it, not super aero. That body position, you know, and if you watch the video I did, which was just kept ringing in my head, is how important body position is to aerodynamics. And so even though this is a climb, you know, out of the saddle standing like this, you know, it's 7%. 6%, I mean, that is slowing me down, right? I'm having to do more watts to maintain the speed. Like if I could do 350 in a very aero position, I would be going faster. So during this effort, I'm definitely thinking about the video of me getting aero. But for me, standing is just more, I just enjoy it. I like standing. It fits me well. Maybe it's because I'm kind of tall, but I could stand at 20 minutes at a time. I've actually done intervals where I've stood for 20 minutes, and then you sit for 10, you stand for 20. I just really like standing. But anyway, it's sometimes not super efficient, especially when you're going fast. I mean, I know 10 miles an hour is not super fast, but it would make a difference given the whole thing. Now, again, in 2012, my time, 42 minutes, 22 seconds. I'd have to assume, though, that I'm on way better gear. Okay, so the wheels that I'm on, these Kadex wheels, are ultra light, ultra stiff. It's a hookless bead. So fast. I mean, this bike on this day was feeling impossibly fast. It's the Canyon Ultimate, right? I've got an SLF Motion oversized pulley system. My seat weighs negative pounds. I mean, the thing is ultra light. So I'd have to assume, plus I've got Velo toes on and a skin suit and an aero helmet, as compared to when I did this in 2012, nothing. I was on an aluminum bike. I was heavy. I was dumb. And so let's say 2 minutes just on the gear alone. So if I don't go sub 40, then what have I been doing for the last 4,000 hours, right? And so when I'm looking at the Strava Live segment on my Wahoo, I'm seeing that I am flirting with going sub 36. So I'm like in the 35. It keeps bouncing between 36 and 35, which I'm thinking, oh, dude, I'm going way too hard. That's such a crazy fast time, you know, to go 7 minutes faster than my best PR on this. And so I'm, again, just kind of waiting for the hammer to drop and me to explode into banana peels. Now, I will say this, that the ketones could be a complete and utter fabrication of my mind, and that it is doing nothing for me. What is doing something for me is the insane massive training block that I am coming off of. So when you train with power and periodization, you will build to a peak. And that peak sometimes is crazy. It is, you know, orders of magnitude higher than what you normally would perform. And so I'm coming off of basically an 8-week training block. I did the entire Zwift Academy, which was I can't recommend that more. If you have Zwift, I highly recommend getting on the Zwift Academy. The workouts are so well designed, and they pull you through the workouts in such a good way, and it teaches you a lot about how to apply power and your energy systems. But I jumped into the Zwift Academy after doing the evacuation training, right? Doing 20 hours a week. I mean, I dug myself into a fatigue hole greater than I ever have. I think my form was negative 80 at one point. Negative 80, right? So when I came out of that and I went to BWR, I was just starting to build into my peak, right? So you kind of destroy yourself, and then you taper and you peak to, you know, your top fitness. At BWR, I was beginning that peak. So I wasn't fully peaking by BWR, which was kind of a bummer. I should have, I guess, thought about that a little bit differently. But so coming into today, after about a week after BWR, bro, I'm flying. It is so insane. The perceived exertion for what power I'm doing and what weight I'm holding is just, for me, bananas. Okay, I'm not a 5 watt per kilo guy. Like, that's just been something I've tried to achieve for a long time. And I'm going to do a full video on how I got to that point and kind of really break down my power numbers over the last 8 years. But here, your boy's peaking. I'm feeling so good. And I felt so good that when I got done, I was like, man, I could have gone harder. I have better legs. And this is what's weird when you peak, dude, is that I wanted more. And I actually went out with Chaz and Nick, and dude, I almost stole a bunch of KOMs. Like, I trophied so many things. I did. So after doing 336 for 35 minutes here, I actually went back down to get a drone shot, and I did basically 400 watts for like 5 minutes. Then we went out with Chaz and Nick, and I ended up doing 360 watts for 12 minutes. And I got a bunch of trophies on the way home. Anyway, dude, today was just like, it was just my day. It was just my day. And I felt super good. We're coming here into the finish, and your boy clocks in a pretty respectable time. I crossed the finish line at 35 minutes, 37 seconds. 35 minutes on this climb is ridiculous. I mean, there were times that sub 40 didn't seem possible. Okay, so going 35 minutes for me is insanity. I definitely left a little bit out on the road. I think that if I paced it harder, I could have maybe dropped 20 seconds, maybe 30 seconds. But here's what's insane. My boy Chaz had the ride of his life. He went out and he did 32 minutes. Now, there's this lure of this climb that Jonathan Vodders had come and did it at 32 minutes, right? At his peak a long time ago. There's been a couple pros that have done this. And so going sub 33 has always sort of been, even though the Strava KOM was 34 minutes, you know, there's always been this, well, before Strava, it was 32 minutes. Well, Chaz went out and just, dude, he's so light and he did so much power. And for him to go 32 minutes is unbelievable. And for me to do the best that I've ever done, and I am 3 minutes off of him, that's crazy. Chaz is gotta be maybe one of the best amateur climbers in California, in the country. Maybe top five in the country amateur climbers. His performance was so, I was like, what the hell, dude? I did so good, and then you just blow me out of the water.
What'd you do?
Yeah, let me hear what you did first.
I think I ran 32 flat.
No, you didn't. That's so insane.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
32 flat?
Well, he said.
I told you, man. Chaz is undoubtedly top three in the nation for amateur climbers. I mean,
for amateur climbers.
Well, like it.
Definitely throw that in there. Not pro.
But I mean, even at a pro level, you're still
could hang a little bit.
Yeah, for sure.
I hope you enjoyed. That was for me, I think, kind of the. I was happy with that. I can't imagine I could have done a whole lot better. The thing is that what's really strange is how much I'm becoming just a workhorse. I could have held that pace for maybe another 30 minutes, but I couldn't have gone any harder, if that makes any sense. So it's like I'm on my limit, so my duration is better, but my top end isn't there. Anyway, I'm happy with the result. No vegan excuses. I do want to say, though, this is brought to you by Alpecin. Caffeine liquid shampoo. Do not drink, it says. I don't know if you've ever seen, but bro, I've got luscious locks. My hair, I mean, I have premium hair genetics, okay? But I want to make sure that it stays that way well into my later ages.
Hey, will it help my bald head?
I don't know if it will take you from bald to not bald, but it could help prevent you continuing to get bald. So it could limit your baldness.
It could stop your baldness at 32.
So there's a code down in the description to get yourself some Alpecin. I have been using it. I really like it. One thing that I really like about this, actually, is that it doesn't strip the oils out of my hair. So I know this is gross. Don't wash my hair a whole lot. Because when I wash my hair and it strips the oils out, I have like an afro. Alpecin, thank you so much for the sponsorship. Chaz has put a lot of energy and time into the video he's making today. He said it's like documentary style. So if you want to check it out, look, Chaz, like I said right now, no joke, he's got to be in the top three amateur climbers. It's really impressive how he's progressed. And, you know, if you ever watched like Jeff Linder and his stuff when he talks about frenemies, you know, look, Chaz is my friend and he's on my team. But he pushes me to be better because I don't want him to beat me. And then vice versa. As soon as I make any gains, all of a sudden Chaz has another 0.5 to his FTP. It's not fair. But anyway, check out his video. It's probably going to be a banger. Anyway.
Yeah.
Got anything else to say?
I think that's it.
Check out his videos. As always, guys, vegan cyclist. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.